Hi, this is Shreyang Siddharth and welcome to the next video of this object-oriented programming. Now, so far we have covered almost all the topics related to the classes and objects. Now, let us talk about the visibility modifiers in case of Kotlin. In case of Kotlin, we have the visibility modifiers of public, protected, internal, and private. And now, in the previous videos, we saw that by default, all the classes and functions are actually by default public in nature. So in Kotlin, everything is public in nature by default. Always remember this. So here inside the IntelliJ IDE, let us explore the visibility modifiers. Now here I am working under myfirst.kt file. So as a top level, whatever classes and functions that I will define here will be by default public in nature. As for example, here, let us take an example of function run and class person. So by default, this function is actually public in nature, right? As we all know from the previous videos. And now here, this class is again public in nature by default. Now, if you specify here, let's say private and also private here, then this method run and this class person is only visible inside myfirst.kt. Now suppose if you create one more class such as, let's say, new Kotlin file, let's say my second. So here inside mysecond.kt, these two functions and classes will not be visible just because we have simply declared it private, right? And earlier it was public, so these two methods and class can be accessed inside myclass.kt if it was public. And now in Kotlin, we have one more modifier of, let's say, internal. So if you declare it internal and also this will as internal, then this method and this class will now be visible within the same module. Now what is the module in case of Kotlin programming? So if you notice inside the project, this Kotlin programming is actually one module. So a module in case of Kotlin programming can be a bunch of Kotlin files or some other files. Such as a module can be a IntelliJ IDE module, Groovy module, Maven module, and so on like that. So here, if you declare it internal, so this function and this class will only be visible within the same module, right? So mysecond.kt will have access to this method and also this class, similar to public. And now next, we have at the end protected. And this protected is not applicable for the high level functions and classes. So if you declare a function right away inside the KT file, then this protected is not applicable. So here it shows some error. The modifier protected is not applicable at top level function. Now same thing applies to the class as well. This protected is not applicable here as well. So here let us remove it. And by default, we are back to again public. Now this was all about the top level functions and classes. Now what about inside the class person? Suppose if I define some variables and functions and also define a derived class, then what will happen? So here I have an open class of person which is actually acting as a superclass for this class of Indian right here. Now suppose if I define private val a equal to 1 inside the class of person, so what will happen inside the class of Indian? So you cannot access this variable a inside the class of Indian just because this is private in nature. So here this variable a is not visible inside the class of Indian just because we have marked it as private. And now let us define protected value b equal to 2. Now here we are using the protected keyword or the modifier. So this value of b is actually visible or can be accessed inside the class of Indian just because it is protected in nature. And now next, we have internal value c equal to 3. So since this is internal, so again b along with c will be now visible inside the class of Indian. And now let us come for the public val d equal to, let's say, 10. And as said, by default, all the classes and functions and also the properties are actually public in nature. So here, we don't have to specify this value d as public explicitly, because by default, it is public in nature. So this value of d is again visible inside the class of Indian. That is, we can access it here, right? Now, what do we mean by exactly by visibility of the functions and classes? Now, suppose inside this class Indian, suppose if I create a function of, let's say, test. And now inside the test, suppose I want to print these values. So here I will simply use the print function, right? Now inside the print method, suppose if I type here, let's say D. Let's type D. So here the compiler will not show some error because this D can be accessed inside the class of Indian as it is by default public. Now let us try this value of C. Let us type C. Now again, C is also visible inside the class of Indian because it is internal in nature. And now let us talk about this protected B. Let us type B, and here again B can be accessed since it is protected in nature. Now let us come to private value of A. Let us type A here, but here the compiler is not happy because cannot access A. It is invisible just because we have marked it private in nature. Right? Now this was about the superclass and the derived class. Now what about some other class where we actually define, let's say, remove this function test. And now here at the top, let us create one more class of, let's say, test class. And now inside this class, let us try to create a method, let's say, testing. Again, to test all the visibility of these variables. Now inside this testing method, if I create the object of this person, let's say var person equal to person, right? Now inside the testing method, that is inside the class that has nothing to do with this class of person, let's see how these modifiers plays their key role. So here inside this, let us print, let's say print person dot d. So here D is now again visible because it is public in nature, right? Now let us try, let's say C. And here C is also visible because it is internal in nature and the internal variables are always visible within the same module. And now let us try B, but now B is actually protected in nature. Now the protected keyword is only applicable to make a value visible inside the subclass, not in some other class, right? So always remember this. The protected keyword will not make your value visible in some other class that has nothing to do with it. Now similarly, if I use person.a, then again it is going to show some error that it is private in nature and we cannot have this value inside the test class, right? So here let me write some comments for you. So here person.a and person.b are not visible because they are private and protected in nature. But person.c and person.d are actually visible because they are internal and public in nature, right? So I guess now you know what are visibility modifiers in case of Kotlin and how it varies in comparison to some other programming language such as Java, right? So this is all for this video. Thank you and have a good day.